Man, that is one ugly metal chick.
What are you talking about? Let me see that.
Here.
Baldrick, that's Danny Filth.
Ooh. Ah, oh. Huh.
Hey guys, what's up? I am aware that it has been quite a while. I got messages from people asking me, did you quit? Are you gone? Is there something wrong or whatever? You know, we haven't seen your videos for quite a while. No, I did not quit. I'm not lazy, as some people said. I say this every video, but you know, it's life, it's work. I have to find a school for Allie to learn Dutch and learn about the country and whatnot. So yeah, if I would have quit, I would have said something, maybe a video or maybe on Facebook, Instagram, somewhere. I'm not one of those YouTubers that quits, fucks off, and never to be seen again. I'm not like that. If I would quit, which I am not planning for a long time, but I would let you guys know. But yeah, it's been a while. I was thinking to myself, like, okay, so what am I gonna do after a while? I have some plans that I need to work out, a series that I want to do. But I just wanted to keep it simple. As you can see in the title, I'm just gonna show you guys some vinyl that I scored lately or the last past weeks. It differs a little bit in genres, which is only good. Of course, I hope that I can show you guys some new bands, that you learn about some new music for you guys to go and check it out on YouTube. And of course, in which case, if you already know all of these bands, then, well, shit happens. And on top of the whole thing that I couldn't upload videos, by the way, was that my computer showed a blue screen. Luckily, my good friend Core, who is very good with computers, managed to reinstall, I think, the whole thing and get it going again. So yeah, that's one of the reasons I couldn't get on my computer and make videos as well. I did lose some information, some pictures, some video footage that I had. For example, I lost my entire list of the CDs that I have. I keep a list on my computer. Some people say use Discogs, but for me, Discogs is not 100%. I think that I have at least 100 releases in my collection that are not on Discogs. And some people say then add them, and I'm like, in that case, I am too lazy. So yeah, I just keep a list, but that list was gone. So I had to redo the entire list. Well, you know.
Baldrick, would you do me a favor?
Hmm?
Would you rewrite my entire CD list?
Yeah.
So, the entire list, do not forget.
Fine!
Okay.
Oh, come on!
So, the first album that I'm going to show you guys is pretty infamous. I hope I use that word correctly. If not, I made myself look like an incredible tool right now. But yeah, since this came out, people have been praising it and hating it. I think that some of you might know where this is going. I'm talking about the band Ghost with their new release, Prequel. I hope prequel. I hope I pronounce that correctly. This is the back of that. This is not a version, by the way, with that extra song from the Pet Shop Boys, if I'm not mistaken, Sin. Yeah. So this is just the regular album. It is pretty nice, though. If you take it out, it's on like a transparent, smoky gray marble. They give it so many words these days, it's hard to figure out what is it exactly it is. It's gray colored. a little bit of a rant about, not about ghosts, but about the people that don't like ghosts. Now, I'm not one of those people that tells you you can't have an opinion on a certain band. I, for one, think that you should just be able to say, like, well, this is absolutely not my taste. Even if you think it's horrible or it sucks or whatever, I mean, I wouldn't suggest you say that something sucks when you're a kind of a known YouTuber, because that turns into a pretty big deal, but I personally think you should be able to tell that. However, as I said on Facebook as well, I think that the people that do not like Ghost and do not like this new album, of course, spent more time on announcing that to the world and everybody in their friends list and everybody that they think wants to hear it than the people that actually like Ghost, and I really do. I think this is not their best effort. It's good, still good. It wouldn't end up in my top 10 of this year, I guess. But they spent more time on telling everybody that they don't like Ghost than the people that actually bought the album, showing it and talking about Ghost like, hey, I like the new album. Yeah, and there are a lot of arguments about Ghost. People that don't like them, they say, like, it's not metal! So? That's not an argument, you know? I mean, I know this is absolutely not metal. To me, this is not metal from... For me, they haven't been metal from their first album off, you know? And you can discuss about that. If some people say it is metal, just let it go, let it be, you know? That's not worth a discussion to me. But, you know, that's me. So if people say, like, it's not metal... Yeah, okay, sure. Okay, so now what? Then you have that argument that people say, I went to a festival, Stonehenge, once, and there was a girl, I was wearing a Ghost bracelet, and she said, like, you might as well just listen to the Blue Oyster Cult. I was like, well, I did, because people kept saying that, you know, Blue Oyster Cult, Blue Oyster Cult. And I was like, but I don't like the Blue Oyster Cult. They're not terrible, but there weren't songs of which I thought, like, oh, this is great, let's buy an album. No. And I said, or I just listen to whatever the fuck I want without being criticized by someone else, you know? I mean, no, you might suggest it, like, hey, if you like that, then you might as well, you know, you might also like the Blue Oyster Cult. That's something different. Instead of saying, like, you might as well just, no. The Blue Oyster Cult does not have songs like Secular Haze, because that's what I asked her, like, does the Blue Oyster Cult also have Secular Haze, the song? She said, like, no. I was like, well, that's the song I like from Ghost. So there's so many arguments, and like I said, it's becoming a little bit of a rant. There's more to come up, so don't worry. But yeah, all those arguments are just plain bullshit, you know? People that say, like, they're a hype. Well, I mean, what do you want? What do you want from Ghost, you know? Somebody says, like, hey, you know, I'm organizing this big fucking festival, Hellfest, Wacken, you name it. You guys can be on the main stage, you know, you get a bunch of money. What do you think Ghost says? Like, ah, oh, nah, never mind. Let some small band from the locals here, let those guys do it. No, those guys want to perform. And if you can get on a main stage and you're being asked to do so, what do you, you know, bullshit. So all those arguments are just plain bullshit. It's getting a very... very old song. It's been sang just, and if you don't, fine, but that's just how it comes over to me, like, oh my god, another one of those. You know, it's almost getting as lame as the whole Trump discussion, you know? Just let it fucking go. Just, oh my god, I'm getting so fucking sick and tired of all the people that have something to say about Trump, and I don't like politics at all, so I'm like, I'll just stick with, in this case, Ghost or metal music, you know? I don't get into that. But yeah, it's getting old, you know? So, like I said, you can have your opinion, you can say whatever you want, but some people are like, I need to convince you that this is shit. I can't handle the fact that you actually like Ghost and I don't, so I'm gonna keep on telling you how much it sucks so I can convince you and change your mind. And that is not gonna happen. So, I think... it's absolutely a good album. I like that cover. I also bought the CD version, so that cover from the Pet Shop Boys is on there. And yeah, if you like Ghost, it's a little bit different than their previous work. This is a bit more pop-ish, and there's nothing wrong with listening to pop or other kinds of music. That's exactly why I said, who cares if it's not metal? I also own a Daft Punk album and some rap even. So don't, you know, mind the negative bullshit. Just buy this, share it, listen to it. And yeah, I have all their albums so far on CD and vinyl together. So yeah, the new Ghost with Prequel, I really think it's a good album. So now we're gonna get to the next one, and Rant. Gotta hydrate myself a little bit. Another band that I'm pretty big fan of is the band Jungle Rot. This is their album What Horrors Await. It's one of their earlier works. This has been released this year as a record store day release, first time on vinyl, and it's been pressed on a orange colored vinyl. I was in Germany with Allie and her parents. Her parents came over to Amsterdam for a week, and in that week they literally did everything. Anne Frank House, Van Gogh Museum, Rijksmuseum, the Keukenhof, which are like fields of flowers. We went out for dinner. We went to Germany for a day, and at a certain point her parents said, like, hey, you know, we're gonna head to the hotel, have a nap, and maybe we can do something tonight. And Allie was like, you know, I'm gonna have a nap too. And I was like, Google, Germany, where was it? Köln? Yeah, we're in Köln. Record store, and I found one. I was like, okay, that's a 10-minute walk. I'll be here. So I used my navigation to find that record store. Now, I must say I forgot which record store it was, just from the top of my head. I'll put a link down there so you guys, if you're around Köln, however you pronounce it, wherever you're from, you can go visit them, because they really had a decent metal department or section. But yeah, Jungle Rot, What Horrors Await is a great album. I only own it on vinyl so far. They're also coming out with a new album this year, and the artwork is just insanely great. For me, this is so far the greatest artwork of this year, and while I'm saying this, I'll show it in screen. Now, again, I kind of forgot the name of the album, but you'll see it in screen. And of course, you'll find all the information you need in the description. So yeah, I'm a big fan of Jungle Rot. For those who know it, of course, know that it's death metal. It's kind of a groovy, sometimes in a lot of cases with a little bit of a slow tempo, groovy kind of death metal. That is Jungle Rot, and I absolutely love them for that. The first new single of their new album to me was absolutely great, so I'm definitely gonna buy that new album. So yeah, go check this one out too. It's limited, released on record store day, What Horrors Await from Jungle Rot. And let's get to the next one, which is, if it looks, by the way, as if I'm sweating my balls off, that's because I am. It's pretty warm outside, and I rather like the cold than the heat, actually. So yeah, that's exactly what's happening right now. I'm trying not to smudge my vinyl covers here. But yeah, the next one is so far one of the best releases of this year. If I'm not mistaken, this is their third full-length album, and I'm talking about the new Skeletal Remains with Devouring Mortality, a release from this year. Absolutely a great fucking album. Their first album was absolutely good. Their second album was better. This is even better than their second album. It's just groovy, it's brutal. I love the vocals, raspy, raw, and it's been released in a couple of different colors, from black to, this one is kind of mustard yellow. This one is limited to 100 pieces. My good friend Eve managed to score us both one of these. If I'm not mistaken, this one comes with, let me see, yeah, there we go, a CD as well, just in a plain plastic cover the CD of the new Skeletal Remains. But I think I will get myself like a digipack or a jewel case from this album as well. So if you've never heard of Skeletal Remains and you like that raw, original, old sounding death metal from, let's say, the 90s, but then a little better produced than back then you should definitely check out Skeletal Remains and their previous releases, because all three definitely worth a buy without listening to it. I can bet you that if you've never heard of these guys, so you like that old school sound, just press buy, listen to it at home, and you'll tell me that I was right, because these guys are just freaking awesome. So go check this one out, Skeletal Remains, Devouring Mortality, absolutely one of the greatest of 2018. Now, if you would ask people where the sound of old school death metal, the original sound, is coming from, where the most bands coming, where the most bands are coming from, then a lot of people would point into the direction of Finland, Sweden, some from Germany, some from the Netherlands. I mean, we've got that old school band Burial, Polluted Inheritance, Pestilence from back then. Some people will point into the direction of America, you know, Immolation is already an older band, have been going on for years. But this one is from Turkey, and I'm talking about the band Engulfed with their album Engulfed in Obscurity, which is this one. It's been released last year by Blood Harvest, and it says www.bloodharvest.se, and if I'm not mistaken, SE means Sweden, so that's a Swedish label. I think this is absolutely great. I mean, you wouldn't immediately think about the Middle Eastern countries, Turkey, Iran, wherever, for some really great old school sounding death metal, but this one is from Turkey. Now, there was one guy on Instagram who was talking about, I don't like them because they're from Turkey. I'm like, because he was from Greek and the Greeks and the Turks don't like each other. And I don't give two shits about that. You know, this is a band, they make music, they're from Turkey. Whether you like the Turks or not is none of my fucking business. So, I mean, it's a band and I don't care where they're from. So, Engulfed from Turkey, I really think these guys deserve some extra praise because it's absolutely great music. This is the back, by the way, of the album. And the vinyl itself is just beautiful. It's gold colored with orange splatter. It's also limited to 100 pieces. And yeah, go check these guys out. If you've never heard of them and you like a little bit of, you know, old school sounding death metal, then go check these guys out, Engulfed. Wow, take another beer. Engulfed in Obscurity from Turkey. So go check them out. And I'll put a link in the description for you guys, so you can click it and listen to the music. Now, since we already went a little bit towards the Middle East, I suppose we stay there for this one. These guys are from Dubai. And I mentioned this album in my best of 2017. I didn't have it back then. I just showed the album and that I still wanted it. I came across this one on Discogs for a very reasonable price. It's limited to 100 pieces. And I'm talking about the new Nerve Cell with Past, Present, Torture, which is this album. Also released last year by Life Force Records, as it says on the back. That's the back of the album and the front. And I must say that I kind of bought this without listening to it for a whole lot, actually. I mean, I have the first two albums of Nerve Cell on CD. So I kind of went with that music to say, like, well, you know, I'm just gonna buy this without listening to it. I think I listened maybe 20 seconds of their new music on YouTube. And then I put it on my want list. This one is, by the way, I'll just show you guys. It's red marbled, red smoke. Like I said, they give it a lot of names these days. It's just kind of a little bit of transparent orange, kind of smoky marbled, whatever. But Yeah, I got it in the mail, and then a day later I was working in my backyard. I was like, oh, let's put on some music while, you know, working out. Not working out, working outside, you know. So yeah, I figured I just put on the new nerve cell, and I was like, holy freaking shit. I tried to work, but I just kept walking inside, like, listening to the new album. I was like, holy shit, it's a beast. Absolutely a fucking beast of an album. Man, these guys are great. I must thank Nerve Cell as well, by the way, because I shared this on my Instagram and of course on Facebook and whatever. And the guys from Nerve Cell just reposted my post from Instagram on their own Instagram and, you know, giving me a shout out and whatever. So guys, thank you absolutely so much. Thanks for this kind of music. It's a great fucking album. If you've never heard of these guys, go check them out. If you like brutality and still really just, it's chaos and structured. It's hard to explain. You'll just have to listen to it. You'll understand what I'm talking about. Absolutely a great freaking album. Past, Present, Torture from Nerve Cell. And that an album that's been on my want list for quite a while. I wanted it on vinyl. I have this on CD. It's quite of an older album, actually. On the back it says 2002, so I'm gonna assume that that's the date or the year that it came out. Some might think, like, you? This? You know? Like, yeah, absolutely. This is a... just I've been playing this so many times at work when I'm not in the mood for death metal. I mean, it doesn't happen a lot, but it does. I just want to have some chill music, but just really great, easy listening, and still, you know, it's, for me, this is a masterpiece. I'm talking about Audioslave with Audioslave. This has been pressed. This is a repress. I'm not exactly sure, but I think from this year, it looks absolutely great. It's a gatefold cover with the guys inside, of course, and of course, the late Chris Cornell. What a shame, what a waste. It's a shitty thing, to say the least, what depression can do to people. I mean, look at the guy from Linkin Park. Come on, dipshit, and the guy from Linkin Park. But yeah, the same thing happened, you know. But what a voice, Chris Cornell, and just an amazing album. Like I said, I have this on CD, and it's a great press. Just black vinyl. If you take out the inner sleeves, there are lyrics and some pictures of the guys. So, yeah, if you've been looking for this as well, then I suggest you go and check out Discogs. That would be the best place to look for this. I think it's absolutely a great album, Audioslave with Audioslave, and it would have been awesome if he, Chris Cornell, and the guys would have made some more music, but that unfortunately is not gonna happen. So go check this one out if you like something different than just death metal, Audioslave with Audioslave. And then a new release from Soul Cellar Records, who back then also did the release of Smothered, which was a devastating release. Unfortunately, we've never heard of Smothered again, which is pretty sad, but maybe in the future they'll get together again and make some new music. In the meanwhile, we can enjoy this one, and I really do enjoy this one. This is the new Womboth with The Great Desolation. That's this album. Great artwork on the front. If you turn it around, you see the guys, the band. And of course, Womboth dates back years, actually. I have here a repress of their first album, Internal Caustic Torments. I have to look because it's Internal Caustic Torments, which is this album. That's a repress of the original. The original is still on my want list, but maybe I'll win the lottery someday and I'm gonna be able to buy it because people will want one of your organs for the original. But yeah, this is absolutely a great album. Just a really old school, one of those obscure albums from back then. 1993, Internal Caustic Torments. This one has two demos on it as well. The Brutal Mites demo from 92 and the Several Shapes 7-inch EP. So that's from a little piece of vinyl from 92 as well. So we got that album, and then when is this been released? It doesn't say. Well, this one is from quite recently, Downfall Rising. This is their other album from Wombath, released by Dark Descent Records. What a surprise. But the new one is just as great as well, The Great Desolation. It's groovy, it's old school, it's just the way I like it. I hope to see these guys live someday again. I don't think I've seen them live so far. But yeah, just check this band out. If you've never heard of these guys, you'll like it. If you like my taste in death metal, then go check them out. And also, of course, Soul Cellar Records, because he's doing a great job with his releases lately. I think he also released the new Gorgoroth, or that's a re-release, I'm not really sure. Just go check him out. All the information from the labels, from the bands, and from whatever is going to be down there. So you guys got something to check out, and of course also the new Wombath. Now I have three more releases, but those are kind of related in the same story, but you'll understand as I progress. I ordered this album that I have here on my lap a little while ago from the website of Listenable Records. Now I'm talking about Funerus with Reduced to Sludge, which is this album. It's been released, if I'm not mistaken, in 2011 by Hellthrasher Productions. Absolutely raw, old school, groovy, just, you know, it gives you a punch in the face when you listen to it. Great freaking album. I ordered from their website, as it said on their website, the limited edition, the brown one, limited to 100 pieces for me and my good friend Eve. You know, we just have that thing where we find something like, oh, let's order two, you know, we just do that. So a little while later, I got the package and it felt light for one vinyl. So I was like, I don't know, they might have made a mistake. And when I took it out, it was just one piece and it was black. So I was kind of disappointed. I was like, wait a minute, I ordered two brown ones, the limited to 100 pieces, not one black one. So I first sent them an email through their website, like, hey guys, what's up? You know, I just, what's happening? I ordered, you know, I got the wrong thing. So I didn't get a response. So I went to Facebook, I sent him a message again, like, dudes, you know, what's going on? And I finally got a message back and they said, like, you know, we don't know what the fuck was going on. We don't know what happened. Somebody made a huge fucking mistake because we never had that brown one to begin with. So I was like, well, that's really fucked up, because I told a friend of mine, like, hey, you know, I scored as a great piece, limited, you know, we both won it. And I only got one. I ordered two vinyl and I got one to begin with. And it's also the wrong color. So yeah, I was heavily disappointed. And he said, like, look, I'll send you another one, another black one, because we still have those. But, you know, I'm really sorry. Just something fucked up, or someone fucked up. You know, we'll send you two vinyl anyway in total. But yeah, we can't deliver you the brown one because we just don't have that one. And he said, like, you know, I understand your disappointment, and to make it up with you, I'm gonna send you something extra. I was like, well, you know, not necessary, but I'm not gonna say no, you know. So so this is absolutely not a complaint to Listenable Records, because this is actually more of a shout out. Like, this is customer service, because I love those guys. They're also on the Netherlands Death Fest every year, if I'm not mistaken. And they have great releases. They do a lot with Immolation. So but in the second package there was an extra black Funerus. And there was also this album, and I've never heard of these guys before. So I put it on my vinyl player and I was like, holy shit, this is absolutely really good. And I'm talking about Undead with False Prophecies. That's this one. Great, grim looking artwork on the front and the back. And I loved the fact that it was colored vinyl. Blue really complements the artwork, the blue artwork on the front. It's also really just, yeah, that original sound of death metal. I know I keep repeating myself. Some people say, like, you always say the same shit. I'm like, yeah, but it doesn't matter what I say. It just matters what you guys think of this. That is what matters, you know. Some people, there was one guy who made a big fucking message, like, you're getting lazy, you only say, like, oh, I like this. Yeah, but that's all. I mean, I'm not Anthony Fantano. As much as I love that guy, you know, I just love to watch his videos, I'm not like that. I don't like to go into that kind of depth about music. I can only show this to you guys and tell you, like, hey, this is fucking awesome. I can explain it a little bit. It's death metal, it's black metal, it's from this country, it's from that country. And then the rest is up to you guys. Go and check it out, listen to it, find it awesome, find it disgusting or whatever. That's it. It's simple. It's music. It's not science or whatever, you know? It just so that's what I do. This is another one of those great old school sounding releases to me, and you might think that I'm fucked up or crazy or deaf or whatever, but to me this had a little bit of an Asphyx feeling. So go check these guys out, because I never heard of them, so I hope you guys never heard of them either. False Prophecies from Undead. And of course, thanks to Listenable Records for sending me that extra Funerus, of course, and that free copy of Undead. And then a little while later, this is not the one that I'm talking about. Hold on, guys, don't leave me yet. A little while later, I was lucky enough to find the brown version of Funerus on Discogs for a reasonable price. So now I have them both. That one is limited to 100 pieces. So yeah, go check out Undead. And of course, Funerus with Reduced to Sludge. Now, I have one more album. I said I had three more releases and not three vinyls, so the Undead and the two Funerus did not count as three. I have one more. And this one has been released by Listenable Records, so that was kind of the connection with the other three. This one doesn't have anything to do with that story anymore, but just that it's all been released by Listenable Records, so that's... Yeah, let's go on. This album is absolutely one of the greatest from this year. I've been exciting for this one for quite a while since I heard that these guys were making a new album. I'm a really big fan of their previous album, which is that one. And I'm not talking about anything here, but I'm talking about that one. So as you can see, their name is Veldt, and this is their new album. That album, by the way, is called Daemonic, the Art of Dantalion. This is their new album, and it's called Sin. It's funny, by the way, that the vinyl version has this artwork, and the CD version has a different artwork, which has been included in the vinyl as a sleeve with lyrics on the back. So if you see this version as a CD, it's the same album as this. So not that you were gonna make a mistake, like, oh, I want to check out that album, and you see this, you think, like, no, that's not the one, that's the one. So what can I say about this? Well, let's say you like Hate Eternal, that chaos, you know, that overwhelming brutality, then you're definitely gonna like this. It's blackened death metal. That's also how they advertise themselves on Facebook. Their page is called Veldt Blackened Death Metal. Absolutely chaos, but just, yeah, just a devastating album. It even has some melodic intros, melodic parts, and still it just keeps on going. Doesn't really let you go for a second on this album. I immediately put it on my vinyl player and played it from the beginning to the end, and I was like stunned. Absolutely a great fucking album. Fun fact, by the way, the word Veldt means field in Dutch. Okay. Not that anybody cares. Okay, let's thought I'd just throw that out there, you know. Fine. But yeah, this has been released on two different colors by Listenable Records. This one is limited to 400 pieces, if I'm not mistaken. It's a blue version of this album. And then we have a limited version, which is limited to 100 pieces, which is a little marbled, transparent red. So they have two vinyl versions. They have also CDs, but there's a CD version. If you check out their Bandcamp, if I'm not mistaken, they also have t-shirts, flags, and whatnot. Just a lot of great looking merchandise, and I absolutely fucking love this album. They made a big promise, like, you know, we're coming with a new album, it's gonna be great and whatever, and of course every time you just have to wait and see if that actually happens. We all know the Morbid Angel story, but these guys came through with their new album, Sin Veldt, the guys from Veldt. Holy fucking shit. Absolutely a great album. And together with Skeletal Remains, probably my two favorite releases from this year. But there's still so much shit coming out. Like I said, the new Jungle Rut's coming out. I heard today that there's a new Solruption coming out. The guys from Sulfur Aeon working on a new album. So I'm really looking forward to that one. But yeah, I hope you guys haven't heard of the bands so far that I've been talking about. Funerus, Engulfed, Nerve Cell. Well, Audioslave is pretty known. Veldt in this case. I hope you guys liked this video. I'm not sure when the next one is going to be, but I think I just kicked my tripod. See, I did it again and again and again. But yeah, I'm not sure when the next one is going to be. I'm going to try to make it as fast as possible. And I'm still sweating my ass off here. I'm going to grab myself another beer because this one is empty. Close to empty. But yeah, like I said, I'm not gone. I didn't quit. I just have a lot to do these days, you know. There's just a lot of stuff that has priority. And trust me, the older you get, the more shit you get to do. So, guys, like I said, I hope you discovered some new music. I hope you, well, liked the opinions on certain things that I mentioned on Ghost and whatnot. Let me know what you thought, and I'll see you guys hopefully really soon. I'm gonna do my best. And yeah, there's still some shit that I need to give away as well. From Everlasting Spew Records, from Raw Skull Records. There's a big fucking package. So yeah, I'm gonna do my best to get that out there. So keep an eye on my channel because there's a lot of stuff to give away and for you guys to win. So guys, see you next video. Cheers. Now it's empty.